Hey everybody, it's Brian. We're going to do a headset review. I get a lot of emails of people saying, "Hey, what headset do you use?" Because your voice actually comes in pretty clear. I've used a couple different headsets. I've switched to wireless simply because I hate the wire; it always just gets wound up. So my first one was the Logitech G930 wireless gaming headset. Not a bad product, but not a great product. Let me explain a little bit here. You can see right here, I don't know if the video is picking up my mouse, but you can see right over the earpiece that little rectangle shape. That actually started cracking over time, so I'd have like sharp pieces of plastic poking out at the side of my head. But worse than that, the sound would just intermittently cut out. It made no sense. You'd be playing a video game or listening to music or doing whatever, and you'd hear it go beep. And that beep sound means that you've already lost sound. Not that you're losing it, but you've already, completely lost it. So I would be re recording a tutorial, and about 5 minutes into it, I'd hear beep. Well, that means, 30 seconds or a minute or 2 minutes of my voice just did not get recorded, and I'd have to start completely over. It was a real pain. Other than that, sound quality was amazing, but a lot of people have issues with this. To the point they've even, like gone out and ripped off the shielding on the dongle and all this other stuff. And I tried everything, even to the point of ripping the shielding off the dongle, and it's still just crap. Then my girlfriend bought me this Creative Sound Blaster Recon 3D Omega wireless headset. Whew, could that name be any longer? Anyways, if you're like me, back in the day, Sound Blaster was like the best product on the market. Well, it's not really true anymore. While I liked the headset, it was a royal pain to set up. I mean, I like things that are just plug and play because life's just too short, right? But you see this little guy here. You have to have this base station, which is like the size of your cell phone. It's actually pretty thick. And you gotta like pair the headset with the base station, and then you gotta install the software, and then the software wasn't detecting it. And then once I got it working, it took me like an hour and a half to actually get it working. Once I got it working, it was rock solid. No sound disconnects like I had with the Logitech G930. However, when I upgraded to Windows 10, and I didn't do an upgrade, I did a fresh install. I just blew away my partition and installed Windows 10 for video gaming. That's when I started having problems. The headset worked completely fine for about a week. And then I had a Windows update, and then it lost sound. And I went, what the heck? So I looked at all the updates that came down, and none of them had anything to do with this headset. And so I did some research and found that my firmware was out of date. So I actually loaded the newest firmware. And then it worked. And then 2 days later, boom, no sound. What the heck? Did some more research. They released yet another firmware. This one was specifically for Windows 10. I said, all right. So I went to install that firmware and it said, your device is not connected. So I'm looking at this going, it's plugged in. I see it's plugged in. Windows even sees that it's plugged in, but it was saying the device is not detected. So the directions I found, you had to strip off and go back what was it, like five versions previous? And reinstall each version of the firmware just to get up to that point, and then it still said device not found. And then every time I rebooted, I would have to start over and reinstall the firmware over and over and over just to get the sound. And finally, I just got sick of it and went back to the Logitech G930 just because it's what I had on the shelf. And for whatever reason, they were rock solid for about 3 weeks. Not a single sound disconnect. I was very happy. I was like, hey, maybe Windows 10 fixed it. And I also had installed the newest version of Ubuntu, so I thought, hey, between the two, maybe it was an OS issue. And then suddenly, sound started dropping. And by dropping, I mean literally every 30 seconds I'd hear that beep. It was just to the point they were unusable. I should also go back to the Sound Blasters. If you try going out to soundblaster.com and looking, you're going to get a big fat server error, 404 not found. Sound Blaster as a company has really kind of gone downhill. I'm not sure what's going on with that, but I just remember back in like the 90s, Sound Blaster was the de facto in sound equipment. So I went to my local Best Buy just because I was frustrated and I really wanted a wireless headset, and I bought a Razer Manowar. And this thing, it's pretty awesome. I'm actually talking on it right now. This microphone actually slides in and out. The only thing that I'm kind of critical about is I actually hear myself talking. This is really weird. I understand why they did it. When you wear sound-canceling headphones and you try to talk, you're used to hearing the sound of your own voice, so your voice will go up and up and up, and you're practically screaming into the microphone just so you can hear your own voice. Well, this actually negates that because your microphone is kind of always on. When you retract it back into the bass, you'll still hear your voice a little bit, but it's much, much quieter. But when it's out all the way, you'll actually hear your voice through the headphones as you speak, which is kind of tripped me out at first, but it's actually, I understand why they did it. In these little, the little triple snake, typical Razer logo, you can configure the color if you install their software. Of course, I did not install their software. I have no intention of doing that, but right out of the box, it just worked. I plugged it in, boom, sound. I have sound on my Mac, I have sound in Windows 10, and I have sound in Linux, and I haven't installed a lick of software. It just worked. These, I thought, were going to be extremely uncomfortable. They are very comfortable. And these are very big headphones. I mean, they're like wearing two coconuts on the side of your head. It looks kind of awkward, but they're very comfortable. I was kind of surprised. Sound quality is amazing. This little micro USB, that's it right there. That's the base station. You literally plug it in and boom, works. It comes with a, I think it's like a 4 or 5 foot USB extension cord with a base station that you can plug it into, but you can plug that right into the side of your laptop and it works. Range, our house is kind of thick. I mean, the walls are kind of thick, so wireless sound doesn't go well with the Logitech. I could go to the refrigerator and it would start cutting out. Sound Blaster, pretty much same thing. It right around the refrigerator, which is maybe 20 feet from my desk, it would start cutting out. The Man of War, they say, I think it was like 100 feet you can get on this thing. I'm not quite getting that, but I can actually go way out in the living room and then it'll cut out, but it comes back on. It's like it's trying. You'll hear it cut in and out. And I went all the way up to my bedroom to get my tablet and it worked just fine. Only cut out once. I was really happy. So, oh yeah, and the big thing about this is you get 7 days of wireless gaming on a single charge. This thing has monster batteries in it and it'll just go and go and go and go. And I've actually found that to be true where, you know, like with the Logitechs and even the Sound Blasters, I would, you know, like on a weekend, let's just admit it, you all do this. You're on a weekend, you're going to play video games all weekend, and then, you know, but you got to plug your headset in. Well, this thing will just go and go. It's kind of crazy. I'm pretty happy with it so far. It was on sale, I think it was like 120-ish dollars. I don't know. I like it. So for those of you kind of looking for headsets, I would highly recommend you stay away from the Logitech. Sound Blaster is great if you're staying on Windows 7, but if you're going to Windows 10, buyer beware. The Razer, absolutely no complaints on this thing so far. Granted, this is only day three. Yeah, here's that little base station I was talking about. This is just a USB extension, and that's, I don't want to call it a base station. It's just got like a little rubber mat underneath it to keep it from sliding around. You just plug the USB thing in, or you can plug it straight into your computer. Little bulky, a little heavy, but other than that, I like it. Oh, and you can adjust the volume and adjust the microphone right on the bottom. You don't have these big bulky buttons you have to worry about. And that's it. So anybody who's been asking me, hey, what should I get? This is what I'm running right now, and I'm pretty happy with it.